Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and in this video, I'm going to show you just a quick programming trick that has to do with swapping values between two variables. So there's a common type of thing that happens where you've got a value in one variable and a value in another variable, and you need them to be switched. So for example, if we wanted to draw a dashed line in processing, so each segment should be either black or white, and every time we draw a line segment, we want to switch to the alternate color. So if we've got black and white stored in two different variables, we need to swap which one is in the variable that we're using and put the other one in the variable that's just for storage. So we define two drawing colors, and then every time we draw, we swap them. So it seems simple enough, and you might think that, you know, we set them up like this, set color A to white and set color B to black. And this will do this. This creates our boxes in memory. This one's called color A, it's an int and it's got 255 in it. This one's color B, it's an int and it's got 0 in it. And then we want to swap these two variables. So how do we go about doing this? In swap version 1, you might think that we can just do this. Set color A to color B and set color B to color A. And that looks like, oh yeah, that should work. But if you think about the fact that programmed statements are executed sequentially one after another, you'll see that this isn't actually going to work. So what happens when we do the first line, color A gets set to 0 and color B is still 0 because we've copied what was in color B into color A. Now we have two variables that both have 0 in them. Now, when we do this line, we copy what was in color A into color B. Well, we've just copied the 0 back in here. So we still have now two variables and they both have black. So that wasn't really a successful swap. This is incorrect. It's not going to give us what we want. So what we need to do when we're swapping values between two variables is we always need a temporary holding variable. And I always, by default, just call this temp. So now we have this third variable, it's called temp. We don't even have to put anything in it. It's empty right now. And so now when we do a swap, there's gonna be three steps. We put one of our colors into temp, we switch another color into the first color, and then we copy what was in temp into the second color. And so let's watch how this happens. So first we copy what was in color A, the 255, into temp. And then we copy what was in B into color A, so the 0 got copied into A. And now we copy what was in temp into B. And so now, although we started with 255 and 0, now they've been swapped successfully to 0 and 255. Okay, so this is a correct solution. So when you want to swap values between two variables, you'll need to use a temp variable. And if you don't, you're going to end up with two variables that are actually the same. So here's an example program of using a swap to do this dashed line. We've got our two colors. We set up our canvas and a blue background, and we initialize our two colors to black and white. Every time we call draw, we swap the colors. And we're coloring the line using the stroke command with color A. So this is the color we're using. Color B is holding the other color. And we're drawing a line based on previous mouse and current mouse. So we're just drawing a line as we draw. And our swap colors function down here actually does that three-step swap with a local temp variable and makes this happen. So let's run processing and show what this looks like here. So here we go, and we're drawing, and as we draw, we've got this swap happening, okay? So that's an example of how to swap variables, and it's a pretty common thing that you have to do often in programming. So just remember to swap values in two variables, use a temp variable to hold one of them, and then do the swap. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.